Hello everyone, the LEGO Fan 14 here with a brand new video discussing Disney's upcoming gold mine. Ice Age Adventures of Buck Wild. Oh, where do we begin with this one? Okay, to begin, I just wanted to mention this was a 15-minute movie. I felt it was going to be too long and no one was going to watch it, so I decided to cut it short to about 5 minutes, or to make it an easier view. So in time there will be spoilers, but I honestly don't really think anyone's going to care about spoilers of this movie. So, this will not be a rant, okay? This will not be like a video explaining why I hate this movie, because I don't hate this movie. I don't really hate anything or anyone. I can't really say I hate some. There's things I dislike. There's nothing I truly, you could say, hate. Like, I can't say I hate a movie. And this movie, Adventure Buck Wild, is no exception. Now, it's a crazy world we're living in. The fact that Disney bought out 20th Century Fox is still something that still baffled me to this day. And I don't know why I keep feeling that's meant to represent some sort of massive. Massive world scale event that will change human history forever. I don't know why I get the feeling something like that will happen if Disney bought out 20th Century Fox and that owned The Simpsons, Avatar, Family Guy, X-Men, Deadpool, a ton of stuff. But the one thing I didn't know that Disney bought out, like I knew they bought out Terminator, they bought out Predator, Alien. And I did not know they also bought out Blue Sky Studios, the studio behind the Ice Age franchise. Not just that, they also made Robot. What else? Snooping Charlie Brown Peanuts the movie, the two Rio films, Epic, Ferdinand, and their official last release, Spies in Disguise. I actually saw it in theaters just because it had Will Smith and Tom Holland. It seemed like a lot of fun. And I actually went multiple times to the theater in 2019. So I was pretty surprised when I realized that was actually the last Blue Sky Studios movie I saw in theater. And I was shocked when I heard that the studio was shutting down due to Disney not considering appropriate to have three big animation studios open at the same time, being Walt Disney's Animation, Pixar, and Blue Sky Studios. And since Blue Sky Studios, literally, their only successes were the Ice Age franchise. And I guess Rio. But apart from those, none of their other films really got off the ground in terms of box office. There were decent kids films and just kind of fell to obscurity. I'm not surprised about this, because I do remember a large marketing push for the Peanuts. I never saw it, but I distinctly remember a Happy Meal collection instead of a McDonald's at a Walmart.
Oh no.
I distinctly remember seeing it twice and it came out really cute, though I never got it. And even now with this, I don't have any like Snoopy. Speaking of which, even if I'm a Lego collector, a long time ago I used to. I got a lot of toys and I even have a few Ice Age figures. Mainly that Manny who's in the intro. I really felt this was a cool opportunity to show off that Manny figure. But I might got to collect a few other things, but that's not the point. The point is that I have this sort of weird personal attachment to Blue Sky Studios. So when I heard it was showing down, I did feel upset. And you might wonder, what does all this have to do with Adventure Buck Wild? Well, turns out, after Disney shut down Blue Sky Studios, it was announced and officially that Disney was going to move on with Ice Age. They were going to do another production, specifically a TV series, a spin-off called Adventure Buck Wild. But later on, it seems like Disney scrapped the idea of
if we don't find them,
the TV
I'm gonna
show
kill them.
And decided to, hey, why don't we just make this a movie and make it an unofficial Ice Age sequel. Now, Ice Age is infamous for being one of those anime franchises people think it went on too far. Like, I still am surprised that there are five Ice Age movies.
And make
it took Toy Story
world.
Around 24 years to get from Toy Story 1 to Toy Story 4. It took about... I believe 15 years for five
those
Ice Age movies
to
be released.
World.
And people mostly agreed that they went down in quality. Like, Ice Age is something very personal to me. It's something I have many memory to it, so I can't really say I felt. I felt the movies were getting worse. I actually saw Collision Course twice in theater. Remember, I can't really say I hate it. I actually still find it funny.
Even
that launch her way into the fact that they don't get really too serious. What's what made me enjoy it? So, just announced this was a movie, and when the trailer came out, I was really
like,
yeah, this guy's serious is definitely not behind this. Now, the animation, it's not horrible, it's not bad, it does feel off, it does feel like a bit lower budget.
Like,
I'm glad that we got this point of animation, even if you think the film can still detail some textures, like the character's fur, and the environment, but at the same time, it didn't feel like Blue Sky Zoo. Like, the reasons I think it was great that Ice Age continued on for as long as it did was because how the animation could be improved on film after film. Like, it's really surprising just when these anime franchises, usually 3D animated, go on for so long that you can feel how the 3D animation changes with the time. Like, how with Toy Story, it still feels so crazy to see the animation on Toy Story 1 and the one on Toy Story 4. But the point is that the animation looks a bit off. Okay, it's not horrible, and I don't even know who's behind it. Like, I know it's not Blue Sky Studios. I know it's not like DisneyWare resourced it to themselves or to Pixar. I think there's like a smaller animation studio behind it, but I don't really know its name. From what I know, they're also behind the Disney Plus animated Diary of Wimpy Kid movies, which I also did a video on that one. The first Diary of Wimpy Kid film was 2021, but that got removed when my little channel shut down. There's a new one called Robert's Rules, but I don't know if I'm gonna watch it. It's not like really gonna make it into my last video of the year, but the point is that when I saw this, I realized it kind of does feel like Disney Kid. Dug Ice Age out of the grave that they themselves did. It really did feel like Disney was just trying to pull out Ice Age and to get every single cent they can out of it, even though already Collision Course wasn't considered a big success. I guess that's why they made it. Wasn't just because you can really feel her to the puzzle. Now, there are many videos of people ranting on why this movie is awful. And they made it more technical point to why these movies are bad. So, I'm not going to bore you with all that info. I'm just going to tell you quickly the most nutshell way possible what people dislike about this movie. Also, stuff I know. First off, they cut off almost every single new character. Just stuck with most of the cast of Ice Age 2, 1 and 2. Boys, and I was surprised, like, they took out a lot of characters. Yeah, some people could think, well, that's great, right? And some people felt like Ice Age was getting kind of too many characters to a point that you didn't even know who was still around. And here, the fact that they ignore them just feels off. Secondly, it's really consistent in its story. And the thing that surprised me the most, only one original cast member returned, being Simon Pegg, aka Buck Wild himself. I can see that this movie felt like a bit of a mess, and I can definitely see why people hate it, but I don't hate it, I just don't really think it needed to happen. Like, I'm glad Collision Course happened, but I really think we could just run on without another Ice Age, and Disney's still moving forward. I believe there's Ice Age 7 in production in a real 3, so I guess Disney just aren't.
Can you repeat this?
Blue Sky Studios.
I had a marshmallow
in my ear. Give this movie a 5 out of 10. I don't think it's off. I actually did like it. You think that? I do feel like Simon Pegg did a great voice. Like again, that's Buck Wild. I do feel like the animators did try to bring his personality. At the same time, the movie has so many thoughtful inconsistencies that just feels like this movie just slapped together. It just feels like this is trying to go back to their infamous 90s and 2000s sequels era. And that's kind of scary to think about. And that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Please let me know down below if you love the Ice Age and how you feel about this new movie.
Family reunion.
That's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching.